Evreka was our dream to improve and optimize waste collection processes because we have seen super inefficient and chaotic process, not only in Turkey, but also in other countries. And we have decided to come up with a solution with our engineering background. And we were focusing on route optimization of those heavy waste collection trucks by using the data coming from our sensors to understand the fullness levels, temperature and location of those containers. Like shortly, we were optimizing the routes of waste collection trucks for waste collection companies and municipalities. Like at the beginning, we said, okay, we would like to be a global company, but as we are developing hardware and software and trying to sell to a difficult customer, we have to prove ourselves to ourselves in Turkey because we have to touch the sensor, we have to understand what's going on in those containers, and we have to understand the customer too. That's why we spent, I would say, too much time in Turkey to understand the real need, to be self-confident about the product, to scale in globally. It brings us some advantages because the cost of living and cost of development and, you know, cost of the team is super low in Turkey compared to Europe or compared to Middle East or compared to US for sure. This was an advantage. And the other advantage that I'm seeing currently is this. Our team is super agile. It's not like European style. They work a lot and they work like day and night. So we are able to provide the best service and best product to our clients, which brings us very, very high potential to sell some of the big waste collection companies globally. We were saying that Turkey was not big enough. It's not big enough, so we have to go global. But the first time that we went out for the expo was like almost 3 years later. All of us said that this is a bit late. If we came here before, it was also good for us because we were able to see competitors and the need of the market. This was really, really good lessons learned for us. 6 months before that day, we were also good enough to be in Italy, to be in Spain, to be in Middle East, whatever. Because we saw our competitors, they were not better than us. Some perspectives, we were better than them. And also we got some really good conversations with some potential clients. Some of them are our current clients, and they were asking some features or some, I don't know, services which we are easily able to provide to them. We are going to somewhere else, like not the devices itself, but we are focusing on the SaaS business, trying to focus on the trucks which are using our systems, and we are aiming to sell our software to all waste collection companies globally. It's gonna be like sales for, I don't know, waste collection and cleaning companies. They are gonna use Evreka for sure for their everyday processes, like from HR management to finance management to CRM to field management and even maintenance. So it's really end-to-end solution. This is an aggressive approach for sure. But as I mentioned, that our software is much more defensible than the hardware part. Like in India, there is one case. We are working in India in more than seven cities right now. Let me explain the case study in India. So there was one Swiss company working on that client before us. But our partner went then and showed our software and our system. They fell in love with our system. But they already have invested the sensor, but they were paying monthly fee for the software itself. And then they asked for integration with their sensor, and they would like to use our software. Then we said, okay, normally we couldn't do it. At that time, we said, this is a nice chance to beat our competitors by using our software only. If you think about the hardware, it brings you more difficulties and potential problems than the defensibility of it. That's why we are now focusing on the software part, which brings us more agility and also aggressive approach in the market. Well, it's not easy to understand the market dynamics from Turkey. It's not easy to understand those areas. First, we have to be there personally, to meet our local partner and to meet our first client in the market.
So number one, be there personally, have a partner, and onboard your first customer.
For sure. And onboard the first customer together with the partner. And they see you, how you are onboarding. So they can say that, okay, this is the CEO of the company. He is doing it, so I'm going to follow him. Like in India, I went there to install the sensors in waste containers. Personally, I was in the container. And they were recording me. Because they were saying that, look at him. He is a CEO and he is in the container. So,
but you love being in containers, don't you?
I do for sure. But this gave them the motivation to get in as well. Because they were just keeping themselves behind. But they see me and then they say, okay, we are going to get in as well.
So rule number two, always have a partner which will take on the business after you leave. And you personally have to teach them how to sell, how to mount the device, and how to maintain it in the long run.
Those partners in those markets are really important. You'll see there will be many, many potential partners coming to you, or you're going to them. But these partners are really important. Like in India, this is a success story, or like in Dubai and Abu Dhabi. Those companies are the companies in waste collection business. They know who can buy, they know who can pay how much, and they know who is the decision maker and whatever. For instance, like for us, waste container companies, either producer or distributors, they are selling, you know, the metal thing to put on your streets, you know, or plastic, whatever. They don't have any specifications, you know, everyone can produce them and everyone can sell those. If they are selling those products, imagine how they can sell your technological product to those, you know, like the same client. I personally believe is Middle East, I would say. They have a motivation to get the best solution in their cities or in their countries, and they are ready to pay for it. In Turkey, for instance, they would like to have the best solution, but they are not ready to pay. Or in Europe, this is a good market as well, like in, I don't know, France, Germany, Spain. They also would like to use the best solution, but there is a competition